hallway was dark. The fluorescent lights flickered overhead. Shadows fell over poster boards. The sounds of whispers. Ventilators drifted down the hall. Her sobs chased after them. Donette hunched over in her seat, her face resting in her hands. An N95 mask laid beside her. Tears fell on her shoes. Her hair a mess. Her ears hurt from wearing that mask. Her heart was broken. Donette leaned back in her seat, resting her head against the wall. She wiped her tears away. A sob lingered in her throat. She listened to the ventilators down the hall, more tears slipping down her cheek. "Hello?" Donette looked at the seat next to her. A little girl stared back. Her brown hair was braided, and she wore a pretty green dress. She kicked out her legs, revealing little white socks and black shoes. She smiled at Donette. "What? You're not supposed to be in here. Where's your mother?" The little girl pointed down the hall toward the sound of ventilators. "Your father?" The little girl pointed again in the same direction. "I'm sorry." The little girl shrugged. "But there are no visitors allowed in here. If your parents..." Donette caught the sob in her throat.
"Why are you so sad?"
Donette looked at the little girl. Her eyes glowed under the fluorescent lights. Her smile warmed Donette's heart. But then she heard the whisper of ventilators. It made her cold.
"Why are you crying?"
"I'm sad." Donette brushed a tear away.
"Why?"
"Because I can't save them." Maybe she shouldn't have said that. "I'm trying to save lives, fuck it. But I'm failing and people are dying." Little girl finished, not fazed by that word. "Yes, dying. Why are you in the hospital?" Little girl touched her hand. Her touch surprised her. It was warm, and Donette felt better. And she patted the little girl's hand.
"It's Christmas."
The little girl said. "Is it? I barely noticed. Actually, I haven't noticed much lately." Donette glanced down the hall.
"I have something for you."
The little girl held a small black box in her hands with a red ribbon. "Where are your parents? Who brought you here? How did you get inside the hospital?" The little girl frowned.
"You're hurting my feelings,"
she said. "I'm sorry. It's okay." The little girl placed the box next to Donette's mask. "When you're ready," she smiled again. Donette turned away, looking down the other end of the hall. "I should find someone. Someone is probably looking for you." She turned back, but the seat next to her was empty. "Hello? Little girl, where did you go?" Donette looked down at her mask. The black box with a red ribbon rested against it. There was no card, no wrapping paper, and the box felt warm in Donette's hand. She gingerly pulled at the red ribbon. She didn't like that the box was black. That usually meant death. And she shuddered, remembering a poor soul from earlier who was put into a black body bag. Donette removed the lid. She saw the silver chain and slowly lifted it up. A large silver heart hung from the chain. It had good weight. The heart shined brighter than the lights overhead, and Donette didn't know why she did it. But she put the necklace on, and it was like a warm embrace. She wrapped her arms around herself and cried, but this time she was not crying from despair. "Thank you," she whispered. "Whoever you were, thank you, and Merry Christmas."